If you're going to solo over a shuffle or a swing feel, you're in that same groove, one, let two, let three, let four, let right. Our layers, let's look at quarter notes. That's what the bass is playing. Well, you obviously it doesn't work very well if it's just straight quarters. So let's look at the swing eights. Now, I've kind of ventured into another area here, single note work. We've been primarily looking at rhythm guitar, but rhythm applies to both lead and rhythm, no matter what you're playing. So the pick strokes on here, the reason I've included this swing example in all this funk is because the direction you're picking has more variables in a swing situation. We're going to discuss this at length. If I'm playing just the swing eighth notes and I have a constant line, for example, I'm going to just play a blues scale. I want to stay in the groove of down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, using the downstroke on the number, the upstroke on the let. One and two and three. But if I play phrases that are short, and they're starting on the beat, I'm going to start with a downstroke. But the problem is that phrasing over a swing rhythm primarily uses phrases that start on the upstroke or on the upbeat. You might say, well, that's easy. I just make sure I start with an upstroke. Well, it's not as simple as that. In a case like here, there's actually, depending upon the tempo, you actually would start on a downstroke. If you start on an upstroke, different feel. There is no right or wrong in this. You need to make sure that you're aware of this and that you practice a phrase both ways. It depends on the tempo, as I said earlier, but it also depends on where you're going. If we play a phrase, it starts on the beat, and then we have a bunch of repetitious offbeat stuff that's on the upbeat. Those are still going to be downstrokes because it's awkward to go. Why do the upstrokes? They don't have the weight and the tone. Use downstrokes. So you might say, how am I helping you on this video lesson for this segment? I'm just talking about your options, and most people tend to neglect what's going on with the right hand. They get so concerned about note selection. When you play these figures and you're in the eighth note groove, make sure that you're thinking about what stroke gives you the sound you want, because you can tie yourself up and limit yourself on phrases. If you insert slurs, that's going to change things quite a bit too. So up to this point, we've just discussed the swing eighth notes. At this tempo, the eighth note triplet's going to be a quick little guy, so we're going to talk about that in the next segment.